guys, it's Jenni C and welcome to my channel. Today, you guys, I decided to make something super delicious, festive for the holidays, but also you can make it anytime. This is my vegan streusel apple pie. To make this apple pie, it's super easy, like literally took me 10 minutes. The longest part was just peeling apples, but basically it takes you like 10, 15 minutes and you just gotta bake it for like 45 minutes and that's it. That's literally it. So let's get into how to make it. Super easy. Here we go. Step number one is you're going to want to peel your apples. You can use any kind of apples you want, really. I just used the cheapest ones I could find. I think the ones I used were Honeycrisp just because they were on sale. But I think if you want your very authentic tasting apple pie, you can use a Granny Smith apple. I used 6 medium-sized apples. So make sure that you have medium-sized apples. If not, if you have large apples, then maybe 4 large apples. And if you have small ones, then maybe 10 or 12 small apples. Once you have your apples peeled, separate your apples and get a cutting board and start cutting them up into slices. So you're gonna remove the core, of course, and you're just gonna cut the slices of the apples to about maybe 1/4 to 1/3 of an inch thick. You can cut it thicker if you like to actually feel that chew of the apple when you're eating apple pie, but if you like a very soft apple pie, then you can even cut it smaller. Go ahead and toss all of the scraps aside, but don't throw them out. You can always compost them. Once you have all of your apple slices cut up, all we're gonna do is then add the ingredients to the apple pie base. So what you're gonna want to do is to start by adding the juice of 1 lime or lemon. I didn't have lemon, so I used lime. Just go ahead and squeeze 1 lime onto your apples. Adding this acidic juice from the lime or lemon is going to help prevent browning in your apples. So that way you'll keep your apples looking more pale color and they won't look brown and oxidized and they won't taste oxidized either. Go ahead and add 3 to 4 tablespoons of flour to your apples. This is going to help absorb the juice and thicken the liquid that forms. Then you're also going to add about 1/2 cup of sugar. Depends how sweet you want it. I went for something more naturally sweet, so a little bit less added sugar. 1/2 cup is pretty much enough to feel a good sweet apple pie flavor. But if you want extra sweetness, add some more sugar. Once you've added that lime, the flour, and the sugar, then you're going to add your cinnamon. So again, totally a preference thing. I love a lot of cinnamon, so I add a lot of cinnamon. But again, you can add as little or as much as you like. Depends just how much cinnamon you like on your cinnamony desserts. So go ahead and mix that up. Also, what you can add is my secret ingredient that I'm gonna let you guys in on the secret. In any sort of sweet dessert, you can add a pinch of salt, which enhances the sweetness of the dessert. It's so weird because you think like adding salt would make it salty, but it doesn't. If you add just a little pinch, it accentuates the sweetness of the dessert. Food science, you guys, it's amazing. Go ahead and mix that up real well. Make sure all the apple slices are covered nicely and set that aside. Now you're gonna need another bowl and we're going to make the streusel topping. Super easy to make. All you're going to need is to add about 1 1/2 cups of flour, 3/4 cup of sugar, so about a 2-to-1 ratio between the flour and the sugar. Then also add some cinnamon to that. Again, a preference thing. However much you want is how much you can add. I recommend about a teaspoon to a tablespoon. Anything more than that may be a lot, so just again, depends how you feel about it. Then again, you can add a little bit of salt, just a pinch, to enhance that sweetness. Go ahead and mix that up, make sure it's fully and evenly distributed, so everything's mixed nice and well. And then you're going to add your vegan butter. For this recipe, to keep it vegan, you can add either vegan butter or coconut oil if you're going for something less processed. I use the I Can't Believe It's Not Butter vegan butter. I added about 1/2 cup to 3/4 cup of butter. Basically, what you want to do is to start off with just a little bit, like about 1/2 cup, and you can add more as you go. So here's where you have to get a little bit handsy and a little bit messy. You're gonna have to use your hands for this one. You don't have to, but it comes out so much better if you do. Just make sure your hands are super clean, like super clean, and then get them in there. You're gonna mix around and just kind of like scrunch and mash and mix everything around. You want to distribute that butter and create little crunchy lumps. If you notice, like I noticed when I was making it, that your streusel looks a little bit dry and crumbs are not forming very well, what you want to do is add a little bit more butter. Like I said, do it a little bit at a time, because if you add way too much, you're gonna get Play-Doh, and then you've gone too far, and then you gotta start adding more flour and sugar, and it's a whole mess. Speaking of a mess, this is gonna make a mess, so make sure you got a little placement around you that's okay to get messy. Now we're gonna pull up our pie baking dish and go ahead and layer down your apples. Pat them down to make sure they're flat and formed nicely into your baking dish. Now, once your apples are all formed into your baking dish, you're going to get your streusel crumbs and just start putting them on top of the apple pie. So here's a technique that may help you in putting down your crumbs, especially if your apple pie is kind of going up instead of being flat. If you just throw the crumbs down, they're just gonna like fall everywhere and just avalanche down sides. So what you're gonna wanna do instead is to use one hand as a little barrier and use the other hand to drop down the crumbs. And then you can just kind of like push them up, you know, push them around, around your apple pie to make sure all of those apple slices are covered up with your streusel. Once your streusel has covered up all of the apple slices, you're ready to go into the oven. Put your apple pie into your oven and leave it in there for about 40 to 45 minutes. Like I did, I checked in on it within like 20 minutes and the top was starting to get a lot darker than the rest of it was. And I was like, heck no, I am not burning this thing, no way. I did not spend all of this love and energy into making this thing for it to burn. So I put a little piece of tin foil on top just to protect it and keep it from burning on the top. If you want to have a little bit of texture to your apples inside of the apple pie, then leave it for less time. But if you like to have very mushy apples in your apple pie, then leave it longer. Make sure you have your protective hand gear on. Remove your apple pie from the oven, place it on a heat safe area, and let it rest and cool down just a little bit, just so that it's not too hot and that it burns your tongue. Once it's cooled down for about 10 to 15 minutes, then get your ice cream ready if you want some ice cream with this, because it definitely goes so well with some vanilla ice cream. Cut from the top down to the side, and again, scoop it out, place it on your serving plate, and dig in. When I tell you guys, this apple pie is so, so good and so easy to make.
Mmm. Oh, wow. Oh, that's good. I'm not even big on apple pie, but this one, damn, that is delicious.
Mmm. Anyway, you guys, I hope you love this video and this recipe and that you try it out. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up and also hit subscribe down below. Make sure you also have that little post notification bell on so that you're notified whenever my videos go up, because then you can come on to my videos early and comment, because I always reply to early comments. I put out a new video every week on Wednesday, so I'll see you guys again next Wednesday. Bye! This is my vegan strudel apple pie. Strudel or streusel? Is it streusel or strudel? Let me look it up real quick, because that's gonna mess it up. It's streusel. It's streusel. How do you say that? Am I saying it right? Pronounce.
Streusel.
Streusel. Okay. Okay, here we go. Let's do that again.